I like that section. It is a need for speed that Jang Woojin has. And Felix there, a rare sight. A European penhold player. Modern penhold. His brother Alexis Lebrun, France's number one.
The good that actually he broke one serve.
Goes for a really wide side spinny serve into the tight forehand of Jang. He's more divisive with the backhand than a lot of players. But we can hunt forehands from seemingly droughty positions.
Felix just actually hunt these balls. Actually, he's looking always forward to these long balls and so that he can actually hunt.
Oh, float serve. Miscontacted it. Great winner from Woojin. Rapid, isn't he, Mr. Fahrenheit, with the footwork.
Great way to actually change the speed of the ball. Yeah.
He's forehand dominant, so he doesn't like to be too powerful with the backhand, otherwise he's going to get a pacey ball back. So he plays it slightly slower with the backhand, Woojin, intentionally. So then he's got more time in the next shot to play the forehand.
Absolutely.
Like his brother Felix, he doesn't take so much time between serves. Has a rushing quality to him.
Yeah. He doesn't want players to think in between the match.
That's, I think, what it is. He's won as a plan and just goes straight to it, Felix. You can really feel that. There's an urgency to him. Woojin, one in front with the pendulum serve. Oh, again, it's miscontacted, and Felix there notioning to his coach. It's kicking. Last second.
Felix seems to be hurried up a little bit while picking up the serve.
Doesn't want to come into it too early. To receive. Fluid as water. The reverse penal backhand.
The stroke was as if they are floating in the air. So swift.
Showing that this penal style is not a dying art yet. Felix Lebrun. Of course, the Europa Meister, Chodan from Germany, also with this style. Ooh, that was a lovely side spinny flick, wasn't it, Sachin?
Yeah, that was. This is an important point.
Ooh, it went long.
Pressure is mounting up.
Just saying, wait a second, please, Felix. And rushing him. It's a good comeback here. A massive kill streak for Felix Lebrun.
Giving negatives towards the late. Nine, something six. What you need to avoid.
He's got Woojin where he wants him. Goodness me, Lebrun. Four game points in the first.
Seven, 10. Felix wanted to finish the ball with his backhand.
Yeah, he went for a big winner.
Difficult
three
one.
Left.
Difficult one it was on the second line.
And that time he does it. Wraps things up. Felix. Into the middle. Woojin's so good at chasing forehands, playing down the middle into his body can be good, but not easy because he's not a tall player, Jang.
I think that's the game actually Jang needs to play. Sometimes you need to slow down the ball because Lebrun is normally a high energy player, and if you give him on the third line, he actually comes back with double the power. You are slowing him down, you are winning the point.
Fresh off the back of his best win ever, Felix beating Charles Maurigard. You can see how much it meant. Because all the Lebruns, both Lebruns and Trolls, want to be the best young players in Europe, and it was a bit of a clout match, that last one against Morrigard, which he won 3-1, didn't even need the decider. Felix has already beaten Chong Chi Wan. That was his breakthrough win. He's beaten Cho Dan, beaten Hiroto Shinazuka twice. Morrigard, and if he can beat Wu Jin as well, he'd just be like, hang on a minute. It's not luck. So over the last 16 points going, the young Frenchman with the spectacles.
I guess he's actually slowing down the Felix right now. And that's where he's winning the point.
Pinning him relentlessly in the backhand side.
What a powerful rally. What a powerful comeback by LeBron. Certainly it must have given him a confidence. He has been losing points. And I think this is what he is looking for.
Again into the backhand side of Zhang Wujin. You wonder if you Wujin, when is Felix going to switch me down the line? And it isn't happening. It's bluff after bluff from LeBron.
Wow, into the body. Got the point. Very much needed by him.
What does Zhang Wujin need to do to stop Felix LeBron from getting in?
I guess he needs to reduce the speed of Felix and play him more on the body.
Round the net from Zhang Wujin, it comes back. Oh, cuts the edge. What drama here in Goa. You will not see that too many times. And the crowd just baffled by that rally.
In fact, Zhang is completely baffled. You don't want that. You can see the rhythm breaking down. You don't want that lucky point to happen when you are trying to come back in the match. You don't want that.
Every neuron in that South Korean mind is going berserk, itching for a semi-final spot. Wujin, he's at his prime age at the end of the day, and Felix LeBron, you would think far from his prime, but already playing at this level. Taking basically no time between serves. Keep that momentum and rhythm.
Felix is trying to play on his strength. He is trying to actually play a little faster, long service and a heavy backhand.
Oh, miscontented the flick and a timeout. Wujin might make it difficult for him to touch here with this kind of serve. Oh, it was a lovely soft hand caressing block.
I guess it was one of the perfect block. I guess he was, if he would have waited a little bit, Zhang would have possibly hit the ball on the table. Quite athletic. I think he's slowly trying to come back. Critical point.
Sometimes when I watch the LeBrons, I'm wondering how much are they thinking? Because they come back to the table at a mindless speed. Are they that quick thinkers? It seems like that. Tough to tell. They seem very academic with those glasses.
Very true. More of, I would say, he has been studying the table tennis and actually he has been speed thinking and speed seeing.
This is pivotal.
Little anger by Felix. He's realizing that he's rushing into the game. He's missing the point. You slow him down, there's a possibility of winning the point.
You look like you wanted it too bad there, Felix LeBron. He's miffed. Going still to the reverse penalty and pendulum into the backhand. That's a greasy spin.
I guess Felix need to possibly draw some learnings from Harimoto. Whenever at the crucial points, he slows down the speed of the ball, gets the body in the rhythm, and then come back heavily.
Great relentless foot footwork and spraying forehands from the formidable Zhang Wujin.
Very electrifying footwork he has.
Honestly, you think about some of the best footwork ever. 2004 Olympic champion Roy Soo-min. He got it, nailed the footwork, the Koreans.
Absolutely.
Especially over the table against a half-long ball and then the ability to transition from backhand to forehand from the backhand side. The only exception really I can think recently is Jung Yung Sik, who's now retired. Very upright style he had, different to the other Koreans.
I guess the way he picked up this ball was really intelligent. Long speed, he actually used the forehand to return the ball.
That's nice. Down the line he goes.
I think this is what Felix needs to play. We need to wait because Zhang is actually playing him in the center of the table on the second line. Zhang was upset with that shot.
Bad receive, and Zhang Wujin on any day is never going to miss those forehands from that
absolutely.
Position.
Absolutely. When you're in the third game, you are absolutely set. You are seeing the ball like a football at the moment, and this ball was punished by Zhang.
Rushes a little bit again, Felix. Just think he needs to gauge his own tempo a little bit better. He's so eager. And he's not thinking. He's just coming to the table wanting to win a point so badly. And this is brilliant. You can't teach desire. But you could teach him to take his time a little bit more.
Zhang seems to be very, very firm with the space. Felix is, has a good game.
Goes for a big over the table forehand kill. Would have been pretty. But Zhang there working up the back of the ball, away from the table, playing with slower spin. Smart shot selection from the South Korean.
I guess Zhang is getting comfortable on the table, and Felix needs to just now do the same things. He needs to slow down, he needs to change the pace of the ball, and try that Zhang is not hitting using his forehand more and more. See, you're getting the point. Zhang backhand is not as fast as Felix, so Felix needs to use his backhand to slow him down and give him variations at different places. Felix is really under pressure. He is really not happy with himself.
That's a heaving topspin from Zhang Wujin, and yes, Felix Lebrun is seething silently now. Doesn't want to get himself a yellow. Put himself under more pressure, Felix. Ooh, it would have been a winner if it would have landed, but no. Snatching the young Frenchman here. Wujin that time with a ripping backhand. He's known for his forehands, but give the backhand time. And that's where he beat Xu Xin in that tournament. And actually, looking back to October, where a lot of stuff happened, really. Alexei Lebrun, Felix's big brother, beat Zhang Wujin. It's too strong for Wujin with the angle and the power. Double trouble for Felix Lebrun.
I think he has an amazing cracker off a forehand.
Takes a lot of inspiration from Ma Long. Zhang Wujin has the same blade as him as well. The way he comes over that shot is top five in the game, I think. Footwork to forehand.
Lebrun really need to actually do something with the placement. He's actually giving the ball in his hand.
Yeah, this is a disadvantage actually of the penhold forehand. It's more difficult to control a tight ball against a reverse pendulum serve because naturally it comes in at a more open angle. And it's awarding Zhang Wujin the third ball forehand kill. He is predatory on that shot, isn't he, Wujin?
Livren seems to be changing the strategy. Certainly it must have given him a confidence. Changing the speed of the ball, changing the serve, changing the placement. I guess where Jang is actually troubling is in the forehand. If he picks up the ball more by his backhand, if he receives the service more by his backhand, I think he should be able to slow down the Jang.
Agreed, agreed. Oh, that's beautiful. The Haramoto strategy, the backhand down the line like that.
I think it's a fairly good comeback stroke. Liberal need to be now play more sensible and more mature game at this point.
He's played in the same tempo the entire match, Felix. If I was him in the fifth, I'd really slow it all down. Throw off Wu Jin.
At the moment, he should be playing point by point.
Loop to loop rallies, and Felix, to be fair, competing with one of the best loop to loopers in the game, Zhang Wujin. Flashback to the summer series where Felix Lebrun lost to Ma Long really, really tightly in the fourth. An unbelievable match to commentate.
It was a musical loop rally.
Yeah, the tempo was there. You can imagine some classical music over the top of it in slow-mo.
Absolutely.
The classic Korean. Forehand chasing, mind racing Wu Jin in the lead. Should I say trailing by two, not in the lead by two. Now one away.
Lebrun needs to somehow make sure that he gets 1 point. He can't be giving it so loosely.
Unbelievable forehand-to-forehand rallies. The timing on that first one from Felix was nice. Wu Jin loves to play in this department.
I think this is the strength of Jang. In fact, both the players are pretty strong with the speed topspin, and this is something what the rally that audience is also looking for. Great backhand. High spinny backhand on the third line. Great comeback by Lebrun. Great comeback. I think this is what he needs to make sure. Whenever the ball is coming little slower and top, he needs to come on top of the ball. Great placement towards the forehand. What a great placement. I think he took a risk and it paid to him. Jang wanted to hit the forehand actually, but Felix very smartly turned the ball on his forehand.
Ooh, you can feel some nerves now. He'd be ecstatic, Felix, if he can get over this unique backhand serve. Change things up. That is such a unique one, especially with the penal grip. You barely see that at all. Cho Dae-sung, the Fan Jendong slayer in the corner. Oh, to the open space. A beautiful way to finish. You can see straight from the serve, Wu Jin wanting to get it onto that short forehand straight away.
Yeah.
Good tactics from the Korean.
This is what he wants. This is what Lebrun should do. Exactly, because he knows that he's trying, he first calls him on the forehand and then hits the ball on the backhand. Perfect change of strategy by Lebrun.
Jang Wujin doesn't play the reverse pendulum serve as much as the normal pendulum. But against Felix's shot four, and it's working well. Here's this serve again. Oh, tried to catch him out. He's got to try and build up the point. a little bit more than try and win it straight away. Ujin is hunting the forehand.
Okay.
Oh.
If you see, both the players are trying to play the ball on the body. Just a point before, he hit the ball on Felix exactly on the body. And this is exactly what Felix did.
Two all. He's got a great reverse penalty backhand. RPB up there with Cho Dang's top two in the game right now. We haven't seen Xu Xin for some time. We know Xu Fei, Xu Haidong up there too as penalty players.
Sports is never easy in the critical moments, and we see these two players are fighting tooth to nail.
Indeed. It's very fine margins between being a champion and a runner-up.
Absolutely. And in this final game, let's see who wins. Experience.
That's a gift. He's flustered. I've got a feeling he might lose his point if he rushes too much.
Yeah. Oh, what a pause. What if we're in with a pause? He first decided to actually just keep the ball short, and then suddenly in the last nanoth second, he decided to hit the ball.
He's carrying his anger from a previous point through to the next point, Felix LeBrun.
Whenever Felix is down, we see that he tries to actually buck him up. He comes up with the energy inside.
The limb is still the 16-year-old. 5-3, Zhang Wujin at the change of ends, two in the lead. Into the middle, wide backhand, good point for him, held by the net.
Good point, actually he's trying to keep him towards the back end, and that's where actually he can steal the points.
Agreed. Oh, he slowed it right down, and that was mature play.
That was a very, very mature backhand by Felix. This is what the magical about this guy is. He brings the complete energy, and he slows down the ball. Wow, the long service on his backhand. This time he couldn't turn back and hit the ball on his forehand.
6-4. Say he won this event, Felix. Say he got 600 points, it'd take him from 70 to top 35 in the world.
Wow.
Double his ranking. That's how heavy the weighing is at these WTT star contenders. India's going to have a special place in his heart regardless.
6-7.
He's pushing the Jang towards his extreme backhand. Jang seems to be a little unhappy.
It's hard for Jang to bomb a backspin ball from the crossover, even with his footwork. 6-7. Oh, kicker serve. Top spin.
What a strategic serve. He knows that Felix is going to use his backhand, and he did at the right time.
There's Jang's backhand. He extends it when he has time, otherwise it's compact.
He literally slapped the ball from his backhand. What a athletic. With a complete power, complete using the core energy. Very, very important point. Ladies and gentlemen, we are watching 2-all.
Wow, he did well to get it out of the middle. But Zhang Wujin can really dominate with that forehand against pretty much anybody.
We can see a 16-year-old using his complete energy. We can see him shouting in the mad.
Even when he loses the point, one of the few to show just to motivate himself. Try and get in the opponent's head and boost his own morale.
Absolutely.
Whoa,
I think match is taking a very, very serious turn right now.
Anything can happen. Yeah, this could go in either way. But Zhang Wujin with a serve and a point up in the business end of this decider. was a great push, but an even better drive. Jang Woojin treating that backspin like it was nothing.
Last time Jang missed the same shot. This time he came back very, very heavily.
It was such a good push, so wide.
He's suddenly not very happy.
Got the serves though, the 16-year-old. In the middle again. One match point remaining.
Great, high energy, slow game. What an amazing point by Felix. I think he needs to repeat the same thing. Slow down the match. You cannot win speed with speed. You have to break the speed.
Ooh. It was a let.
Little confusion. Felix wanted this point.
Needs this, Felix, to remain here in Goa. Oh my God! That had to go on the table, had to go to the open space. The pressure couldn't have been higher, but he counters the Jang Woojin speciality straight past South Korea's number one. As clutch as can be, balanced on a knife edge. Who will make the cut?
Felix did the right thing by using his backhand. Possibly he should have slowed it down. At this point of time, slow it down. Keep the ball on the table.
He saved another. Third match point saved. Can he now get one of his own? This is such high drama.
This is an interesting phase going on. This time, Felix actually did the little slide-out push, and he got the point. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, decider match, semi-final. Experience versus youth.
And now he's got a game point and a match point. Screams a throw into the corner.
Can you see the roar? Can you see the roar by the young guy? I'm loving the energy. I'm loving the energy. And I think that's what the spectator wants. I can see that. You know what, Fraser? The entire stadium is standing right now.